Hi, and thank you for joining us today to hear about how SAGE has developed SAGE research methods to meet how research methods are being taught at the university. I'm Melissa Crowley, I'm a marketing manager at SAGE Publishing. Now, no discussion of research methods in SAGE would be complete without taking a little look at our history. So SAGE was founded in 1965 by Sarah Miller McCune as an independent publisher dedicated to the social sciences. Research methods has been at the core of SAGE's publishing program since the 1970s. In 1970, the first book was published, Public Policy Evaluation, and in 1972, SAGE launched their first methods journal, Sociological Methods in Research. In 1976, SAGE started publishing the Quantitative Applications in the Social Sciences series, affectionately known now as the Little Green Books. Now, these books are short monographs focused on quantitative methods. So every book covers a different statistical or quantitative research method. These have quickly become beloved by grad students and faculty alike. Our own executive director of market research, Elizabeth Leonard, remembers when she was working on her dissertation, the frustration that she would feel. She would, you know, put a little green book on hold at the library. It would finally come, she'd get it home, and it would be recalled before she'd had a chance to read it. So we knew that there was a lot of demand for this content and that a few print copies in the library weren't cutting it. So as ebooks grew in popularity with academic libraries, we developed a platform for our research methods content and launched SAGE Research Methods Online in 2011. We've since dropped the online from the name. But this is a platform that houses hundreds of books, articles, and reference works on research methods. And we also wanted to include tools that would guide researchers, particularly newer researchers, through the research process. So one of the things we developed was the methods map. Now, this is a visual representation of research methods terms and concepts and how they relate to each other. As you can see, the methods map as it is now is very linear. I think this was an opportunity where we had a great idea, but we weren't quite able to realize it with the technology available at the time. Well, I'm happy to announce that this summer, SAGE Research Methods is migrating to a new and improved platform. And this is what the methods map is going to look like. You can see there's a much clearer picture of the term, kind of the broader terms, which the term you're looking at falls under, and the narrower terms which fall under the term. Now, the methods map is a great tool for students who aren't quite sure what method to use. They might be a brand new researcher and their professor has told them that they need to do a qualitative research methods project. Well, what's a qualitative method? They can click through at the highest level just to qualitative research, and then they'll see the terms of methods that fall under qualitative research. As they scroll through, they might see, oh, a focus group. I've heard of that, I know what a focus group is. And then they can click through on the methods map, get a short definition as you see in the screenshot, and then it links directly to the content in the database from the methods map. We also wanted to create tools for professors who are teaching research methods or overseeing student research. So the methods list is an example of a tool that really helps faculty. We have, you know, you can create your reading list or save a search and make it just available to you through your personal login, or you can choose to make a methods list public. So a faculty member can pull together chapters, articles, or even full books into a methods list and make it public and then give the link to their students through either their course management system or on their syllabus. Mine. As we talk to students and faculty who are using SAGE research methods over the years, one of the things that kept coming up was that students wanted more examples from their own discipline. A lot of the content in SAGE research methods is discipline agnostic. It's a book on how to do a survey, and it just talks about how to do a survey. It could be used in business or politics or psychology, but the actual book isn't specific to any one discipline. Well, students really wanted to see that application for their discipline. Librarians told us a lot of students would go to the platform and they'd enter kind of their research topic instead of a method. So we took that back and we thought about how we could address that need. And we came up with SAGE research methods cases. This is a collection of more than 500 case studies written by real researchers in the field. And they really focus, instead of on the outcome of the research project or the research question, they really focus on research design. So how the researcher chose a method, how they applied that method to their project, and how it went. Because, you know, if you read a book about a survey, it's sort of best case scenario. But with these case studies, you can see the bumps and the hurdles that come up in the midst of a research project, and then how the researcher reacts to them. So we wanted these, we thought these had a great classroom application. So we added some pedagogical tools to each case study. Every study begins with learning outcomes and ends with exercises and discussion questions. So these can be easily adapted into course assignments and activities. Ursula at Nova Southeastern University will assign a case study to her course, and these are PhD level students who are just getting ready to start their dissertation. So she'll assign the case as reading, and then when the students come together in class, they break up into groups and discuss the case, and they break out each step of the research project and how it's addressed in the case study. Then, since they're planning their own research, she kind of brings all the groups together, and then they talk about each step and how they're going to address that step of the process in their own project. So they could do something similar to what the case study researcher did, or something completely different. Another thing we learned talking to faculty was there's a real need for data. So Thomas Carsey at Chapel Hill says data is everywhere, but clean, accessible, organized, and well-documented data is much harder to find. So faculty teaching methods, particularly the qualitative methods, need data for students to use in assignments or in test questions or just to practice. They're learning a statistical technique, and they just need to run the calculation a couple times to have it under the belt. They need something to practice with. So you can find lots of data online, but usually the files are too big and too overwhelming for students, particularly for beginning students. So what we've done is we've taken these national surveys or raw data from academic research, and we've pared it down and we've optimized it for student use. So this is the editing work that faculty were doing themselves, and now Sage is doing it for them to save them hours and hours of time and to give them more sample data sets to draw on. So Sage Research Methods data sets launched in 2015. We have about 125 data sets on the platform now, and like cases, they can be searched by discipline or the actual method. So now as we look to the future, we've in our research with students and faculty, something that's really gaining popularity is streaming video. So 68% of students are assigned video to watch for their courses, but nearly 79% of students that we surveyed are finding video themselves outside of class, either to review something that was talked about in class, to go deeper into a topic that was introduced in class, or to, you know, kind of have a repetitive classroom experience so they can master a concept or technique. Well, what's out there for research methods? There's not much. We talked to Kakali at Kansas State University, and she says, if I'm teaching and try to go to YouTube to find something, even something small for research methods, I don't have anything, so I have to make my own video with my students. So here's another instance where faculty are spending hours and hours trying to create something simple to use in class. So we are launching Sage Research Methods Video, which will have hundreds of videos, over 120 hours of streaming video content, all on research methods. So included will be experts explaining a particular topic or method, and then we'll also be able to show methods in action. I think it's one thing to read about a focus group, what it is, get the academic definition, but it's a much more powerful experience to see a focus group being run. So we have several examples of research as it's being conducted rather than just being talked about. There's also a full 15-hour introductory statistics course. So if a student has gone to class, they've just covered regression, but they're just confused, and it's late at night, they're doing their homework, and they just don't get it. you know, they're banging their head against the textbook, they can go into SAGE Research Methods video. And from that statistics course that's been videoed and included in the collection, they can pull up the lesson on regression, and they can, you know, listen to the professor speaking, follow along on a running transcript, stop, repeat, really slow it down to their level until they fully master it. So finally, you know, as we keep talking with our customers and with people who are using SAGE Research Methods, we've taken notebooks and notebooks full of their feedback and experiences, and we've really tried to incorporate that all into the new platform that will launch this summer. So one thing we heard is a lot of frustration over the search functionality. So that's been completely redone. There's new tagging on all of the content on the back end. We've added synonym searching, a lot of new functionality to make searching easier. Another thing that we heard is that there's so much information on SAGE Research Methods that students are completely overwhelmed. They don't know exactly which kind of content they should be using and when. So what we've done on the homepage, if you can see, is that we've split out the different content types and then kind of given a tiny use case for what it might be used for. So if they want to watch methods come alive, they can go into video. If they want to practice data analysis, they can go directly into the data sets. If they want to learn from stories of real research, they can go into the case study. So it guides students a little bit more through the process. In a similar vein, we're working on a tool that's preliminarily called Project Planner. And this will be a step-by-step guide through the research process. So students can look at, they can have a step-by-step breakdown of the research process. They can have a little bit of introductory content, and then it will guide them to additional content that they need to complete their project in the database. So we're excited for our new website and what the future holds. So if anything, I hope you've taken away that we're always listening to our customers. So if you have any questions or feedback about SAGE Research Methods, please email me at the email address here. If you haven't used SAGE Research Methods before and want to get a trial, please email me for that as well. So thank you, and I hope you have a wonderful rest of your ER&L.